All right, hello and welcome to another episode of Bradford City Career Mode. It feels like forever out since I've actually done one of these, but it's only been since Friday since I actually played the game, so I'm a little rusty, which is going to be my excuse if I lose today. But if you haven't looked at the table recently, we have slipped up quite a bit recently, and we are now within touching distance of Burnley. Yeah, that's what it looks like right now. We've kind of messed up a little bit, and even worse, to make matters even worse, we played against Burnley in our last game in the league, and we unfortunately succumbed to a 3-2 defeat. And as you can see, the month doesn't get any fucking easier. We've got Leeds up next in the West Yorkshire Derby, followed by Everton in the round of 32 of the FA Cup, followed by Man City in the second round of, or the second leg of the Carabao Cup semi-finals. And then we finish off with another West Yorkshire Derby at Huddersfield. So January is a hard month, and then we move into February. There'll be even more games because we might progress to the Carabao Cup final, or possibly even the round of 16 of the FA Cup. Who knows? And that'll be in episode 200, so it'll be one big bundle of fun. But anyway, we have got quite tired players. So we're going to do a little bit of rotating, especially since we've got Everton coming up. Hopefully they play a somewhat chilled out, relaxed kind of squad. But I don't know if it's going to happen like that, to be honest. I'll put Tomori in for Hennessy, because I really don't want... no, why is it? Why is my left stick so sensitive that it just takes up my goalkeeper instead? Let's see who else. I think that's all. We've sent a couple of players out on loan, which is why we haven't got as many reserves anymore. So that's explaining that. The rest of the team, we should be okay. I think that should be fine. Hopefully we can roll with that. I think we had a pre-match press conference as well, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, we'll go into that quickly. Get that out of the way. Get that sorted.
Okay, guys. Thanks very much. We'll start the questions now.
It's been months since we've seen any goals come from Greenwood, which calls into his question his ability to score in high-pressure matches. Can he excel past recent poor performances? It has been a while. It has been a while since Greenwood scored. He's got a point. He understands what he has to do, though. Greenwood isn't the first star player to run into a patch of trouble. He understands what he has to do, and it's our job to help him out. He does create quite a lot. He doesn't have to necessarily be that striker. How have you prepared for the next match against your rival, Leeds United? I've told them they have to win, otherwise they're not getting any paychecks. Performance must be better. I truly hope the lads will do better in this match. I'll be truly disappointed if we don't get a favourable result. That's the first time in a while I think I picked a negative answer, but we do need a good performance. Last time you scored two goals on Leeds United to make it look easy, will you be able to beat them again? I hope so. Lads have what it takes. I can't say what Leeds United's manager's strategy is for this game, but I know the lads are more than prepared to face them again. Let's just hope so. Let's just hope that I don't absolutely fuck this up completely. Let's hope I have some self-control and I'm able to, you know, do the old thing of winning. Well, let's take a look at our last game against Leeds, because I actually forgot the result. Obviously, we scored 2 on them, but how many did they score on us? Oh, there they are. 13th November. It was a 2-0 victory away at Elland Road. So now we're back at the Valley Parade. And we need to try and do a thing here where we beat them. So, yeah, but you see the news here. Valley grabs brace as Burnley win over Bradford. Valley was in superb form for Burnley, scoring a brace that powered his side to a 3-2 win against Bradford City. Our undefeated run ended because of that, and I don't think we had any team of the weakers. Oh, we did, we had Sadibo. Okay, that's not too bad there, though Neil, surprisingly, didn't put Valley in there. Bradford looking for a win against Leeds. Bradford City will be looking forward to a win if the 2-0 win in their last encounter with Leeds United was any indication of how today's result will go. Right, don't count me yet out yet, says Sadibo. I mean, he wasn't even cut out in the first place. But anyway, let's go in and take on our local rivals and hope for a victory. Anything less will not be accepted. I don't care about the rest of the results. Turn off goal news except for the Burnley match. Where are you? Versus Wigan. Okay. So we've got Rossi in goal, Kakachi at left back, Sterling at right back, Tomori and Tadebo at centre back, Carbonero, O'Leary and Greenwood in the midfield, Banks on the left, Hloszczyk on the right, and Haaland up the middle. Hopefully a winning formula in this local derby. Can only hope. Advanced pass ground gold. I could probably get quite a good score on this if I wanted to. I'm not going to. I'm just going to get to the game.
what a game we have in store for.
If there's any lag or any problems with the video, by the way, the weather is awful. So we'll put it down to that.
Stay tuned, we'll have all the action for you.
I apologize in advance if that does happen. Very close to episode 200 now. I believe this is 197. Huddersfield will be the start of the 200th episode. I believe it will end when we go to the end of February, I think. Which I think when we should end it. It's going to be an incredibly long episode to upload, but luckily it's only once every 100. League leaders Bradford City, only top now by a point. It's local rivals Leeds United. We've slipped a little bit in recent weeks, and I really want Yotta to come back and help us. But we don't get him for now 2 months. So we need to try and soldier on as we are. The lineups here, Bradford City, the usual suspects, I think, more or less. Minus a couple of them. I would love to get another striker in. Oh, we're still undefined. Okay, cool. Grimo doesn't fix itself yet. And then we'll see Leeds squad followed by undefined. Pico Casilla and goal, Vedan as well. Strong lineup, strong bench as well. It's still got Cleese on the bench, who was actually a goal scorer last season, season 3. A big goal scorer for Leeds. Undefined again. 4-1-4-1. Similar to a formation we played earlier in his career mode. I don't remember when. I've been switching it up every time in this career mode. Anyway, we'll be kicking off here at the Viper Parade, and we can't get anything less than a win here. Anything less than a win could send Burnley to the top. Greenwood onto O'Leary. Feels weird playing FIFA after all I've played the past couple of days is 2K20 and Fortnite. And a bit of Rocket League as well, I guess. FIFA feels a bit weird.
Kevin Dix. And now it's Phillips.
Hopefully no mess ups here. Fadibo, or tomorrow, sorry, I should say, closed down. That doesn't... It's not fully away. In fact, it's actually back in. Will he find the net? Oh, God, that was close. Okay, that was too close for comfort, really. Portshaw tried to score from an impossible angle after the initial Rossi save, and that obviously didn't work. If he scores from there, I'd give him, like, player of the season, goal of the season, whatever. But he did miss. It's rainy weather here in Bradford. Geared wins the ball and immediately loses it. We've got the most goals in the league with 79. Which is one good stat. And we're also top of the league, which is also another good stat. Does it mean this game suddenly got harder? I feel like the difficulty's gone higher, and I haven't switched it off for world class, so that's not it. He's feeling the pressure here. Haaland. O'Leary. Picks up Logic on the right if he can reach. Yep.
Looking confident with the ball that it's beat.
Well, no one was on the edge of the... No one was on the edge of the fucking box, and everyone in the box is marked. What do you want me to do? I was going to cut back, but I didn't realise I didn't know if there was any points, so we'll take the corner instead. Bank standing on it. Delivered to Haaland. Oh no. Good header, just not on target, unfortunately. Close but no cigar.
Well, he'd be disappointed about that end product, but he'd be happy they're creating a chance or two.
See ya. Looking for Vedan. Tomorrow could get there in front of him. But it's going to go to O'Leary instead, who's just going to fucking run into the cunt.
Roberts. And the box has it.
Greenwood initially intercepts, but it doesn't matter really. Sterling comes across, and Greenwood does get the ball now. Holosek. Dude. There's just Leeds players fucking everywhere. Can I get some space to think for a second? About what player I want to make next? Holy Christ. Kind of hoping Wigan pull off an upset. I don't think they will, because it just is not. It's me.
Moving the ball nicely, looking for that final pass.
Good block by Tomori. Struggling because I want to switch a player. By the time I've switched that player, the player's already passed him by.
Crossing into the middle. Was an important piece of defending.
Defended by Tomori again. Making sure Vedant can't do anything about it. Smart move. Horshaw, mid plate close here, we don't know what plan is. He's going to go for a long corner. Rossi unable to catch. Press to clear, but got tackled, so that's kind of how it goes. One of my players is down. Slightly concerning. He's going to go for another corner. Tomori may have picked up a little knock there. I don't know if Hennessy might have to come on early. Vedant gets his shot, blocked by Tadebo. Mendoza now in the corner for Leeds. We are fucking struggling with career mode right now. I don't know. Maybe the novelty's worn off. I don't know. I'm just launching it, honestly. Goalkeeper way out of his area here. Kicking it off the pitch. Possibly the best move. But goalkeeper might want to get back. Oh, I was just trying to throw it fast so I could get a shot off, but I'll go back at his goal, which is kind of ruining it. Blaszczyk, make a move, lad. Don't just stand there behind your man. That's just fucking stupid, isn't it? Realistically. Please, guys, I'll make a movements. Except for that guy. Banks. Haaland. Gets surrounded by two players immediately and can't do fucking jack shit. Green was going to intercept. O'Leary. Oh, give me knock through to Haaland instead. And it's 1-0. You don't let Erling Braut Haaland through like that. How have the defences in this league not learned? Haaland once again the scorer in the Bradford City game. Played through perfectly by O'Leary, I believe it was. And Haaland all the time in the world. Defender can't keep up with him. Tomori seems to have healed now, although it is still suggesting a sub him. Maybe because he's trash, I don't know. Not joking. Tomori's actually been the better centre-back so far this game.
Well, he's got to be delighted with his players. A big smile.
Haaland buries it, though, bottom left. And that's exactly what we needed. 29th goal in the 29th minute for number 28. Almost lined up. Who's number 29? That would have been perfect. Erling Braut Haaland scores the opener here at the Valley Parade. So that was what we needed in terms of a confidence boost. Roberts. Up next, though, in the FA Cup, we've got Everton, so that's going to be a fun one to play.
Roberts. Mendoza. It's neat passing. Confidence
on Tadebo headers it away. They come back to a Leeds player, but it's going to go to the gloves of Rossi, which is all good in the hood. Tadebo, Greenwood. Loshek asking for it through. Receiving. Off to Greenwood. I thought it might be a chance of Greenwood turning this fucking drought apparently that he's on. I didn't realise he was on such a drought that he was going to get into the media, but I thought I could go alone with Loshek. I saw Greenwood and I thought, hey, we'll give it a try. Didn't work out, unfortunately. Mendoza versus Sterling in a foot race. Sterling winning the foot race and the throw-in for his team. Ain't too shabby. O'Leary. That's not where I aimed it.
Could it keep the ball?
I aimed it fully for Hloszek, and I think everyone would even know that I was trying to get it to Hloszek there, but It's all right. End of the day. Still 1-0 up and they're giving away possession. Fine with me. Banks. Not bad. Didn't want to throw it to Kakachi, but we've got possession anyway, so guess not really many complaints that can be had. Loshek out on the right. Back into not quite back into Haaland. Intercepted, unfortunately. O'Leary. Can't, dude. Where's Sterling at? Look, if Maury's there. Get it away again. Carbonero. And one more to Banks. Haaland the target. Oh, it's headed away. I don't know how Haaland's beaten in the air, but he has. Tadebo intercepts though. O'Leary. Greenwood. Legitimately. I don't know what's going on with Greenwood right now. I passed it off there way before he got tackled and just didn't register. Greenwood. Carbonero. Haaland, not really where I wanted it to go, but is that a pen? Oh no, it's not. We've still got the ball. We're going to win a corner. I'm not sure, you know. I thought it was a penalty personally, but that's why I stopped. I was just standing there. I was like, penalty? It wasn't, obviously, because we've now got a corner at the end of the first half here, but for a second, for a brief second, I thought Haaland had the best chance in the world to get his 30th league goal of the season. Lost out the target. Just wide 10.5. Unfortunate there for Bradford not to go 2-0 up at either of those points, but goal, of course, has come from our main marksman, Erling Braut Haaland. And we have a 1-0 lead heading into half time at the Valley Parade, which couldn't be sweeter right now. Take a look around at the grounds. Burnley winning 1-0 despite the game deciding, hey, I'm not going to tell them the goal news. Leave it a secret. That's the only game I really care about. If any of your teams are up there and you care about them, you can pause the video and take a look. 4 shots of 1 on target for us, 5 shots of 1 on target for Leeds. Not really accurate shots today, but there has been chances. And hopefully we'll continue to create some more and get a victory here. Secure the victory, I should say, in the second half. We drop points here, Burnley go top. Simple. Couldn't be more simple. But Sterling doesn't want to do his job, so Hloshik's going to have to track back 9 miles. And the puck has it. Mendoza. Mendoza's a little prick. He's annoying.
That's how to flummox the opposing defender. Well, they want that equaliser, but the passing remains smooth.
Okay, I'll try to head it with Tadebo. Tomori just jumped in the way. Fucking head it away for a corner. You know, that's fine. As long as they don't score from it. It's, no, I've said that. They probably will. Corner to Leeds earlier in the second half. Mendoza on the corner. Leeds player offering himself up close, but it doesn't matter. Carbonero gets there. And Banks is going to get it away. Loshek now. Leeds trying to get men back desperately. Haaland. This could be a counter-attack here. It could be number 30. And it isn't. Yes, it is. Erling Braut Haaland has gone into 30 goals for the league season. This man is on a mission right now in the championship.
Well, here's the replay. I never like rebound goals off goalkeepers. The defenders should be there.
I don't like rebound goals either, but I'll take them if they're going to be on offer.
Let's have another view of that goal.
Haaland heads it in. 2-0 here. And Haaland's got his 30th of the season.
He's delighted. They've been bossing this game up to now.
In the league, anyway.
So 2-0 now.
Bradford City. 2 to the good here against their West Yorkshire rivals, just like they were back at Elland Road. But this time we're only 52 minutes in. 53 now.
Possession certainly isn't a problem for Leeds. However, after that, the coach will be disappointed.
Yeah, Leeds holding on to the ball quite a lot, but not really creating anything with it. And that's a problem. Greenwood. Especially all the way through to Haaland. That was a bit of a expectant pass. That's not where I fucking played it. Stevens may have some room on the left here, or on the right, I should say. Catcher can't get back, but he can. Cut the run off at least, anyway. That's exactly what I wanted. Kevin Dix. He's trying to pass a way through here. And it might work. But what happened to my defence? Just wouldn't lock onto any of them. But we've got it clear anyway. Save from Rossi in a clearance. I thought I had that run marked, but I guess I didn't. Shots wide. Oh, it's a save. We're bringing in Anisimo for Greenwood. In fact, actually, no, we won't. I'm going to give Greenwood a little chance up front to break his goal-scoring drought thing that the game's complaining about. So Haaland's going to get a break. He's got a double today. And we need to try and keep him somewhat fit. As fit as we can for the Everton game. So double substitution though for Leeds. We'll see who they are once Bradford have made their change. We know that's going to be Haaland coming off for Anisimov. Just so Greenwood can move up into that striker role. See if we can get his drought ended or whatever. Leeds corner though. Dallas coming on for Bruma. And Sibiki coming off of Vedant.
Will he play it in? Well blocked, but he must
clear it away. Carbonero.
Now, counter-attacking possibilities.
Carbonero.
Real chance.
All the pace in the world, all the time in the world. And he's going to lay it off to Andrew Banks. Unselfish. I believe it's Banks anyway. Yeah, it is. Carbonero's pace just blistering past every Leeds player there. Could have gone alone. Unselfish from Johan Carbonero. I was wanting to go to Greenwood, but he was marked. He went to Banks instead, but that doesn't matter. I'm pretty sure that caps off another good display here from Bradford City. We've been slipping up a little bit recently, but we've always had our good displays, and this is a performance that I'm proud of right now. Andrew Banks. Only 4 goals in the championship. Doesn't score a lot, but he has been a key player in this championship season. He's going to be a key player for seasons to come as well. 17 years of age, 80 rated. He might be 18 now, actually. I'm not sure, but very young and 80 rated already. This is a point I'm trying to make. And I will show you guys something if the other deal... I was going for a transfer deal. Pretty sure in the last episode. If it comes off, I'll show you what we've got. Oh, actually, no, I'll just show you the end of the transfer window, because that'll be soon. Oh, dude. Joe Gomez has gone to Paris Saint-Germain. Kache able to come across there. O'Leary. Greenwood. Drought ends. Microphone is having a mess. Nightmare. But the drought ends for Mason Greenwood. And it's 4-0 at Bradford City.
This
weather is awful outside.
Football.
Holy Christ.
He dribbles past him as if he isn't there. What a goal.
That's fine. I don't care about the weather. All I care about is this demolition of our West Yorkshire rivals right now.
Well, there's nothing better than Bradford
City come to life in the second half.
Total satisfaction.
And Greenwood ends his drought and gets his 17th goal for a championship season. So it's not like he's had a bad season by any stretch. But 4-0 now to Bradford City. May not have the possession a lot of the time, or the possession advantage, I should say, a lot of the time in matches. But we are a good team. O'Leary, Carbonero, Greenwood on again. And it could be 5. Oh, I thought Casilla was going to make as much of a mistake there that it would just go into the net. O'Leary turns. Greenwood stays on, I think. No, he didn't. Saved anyway. Didn't stay on, though, unfortunately. Substitution. Now Stevens coming off. Can only assume that it's going to be Cleish coming on. But I don't know the number of Cleish, so it might not be. No, Wilson. Okay. Well, it's starting. Cleish was a very good player for them last season. They haven't played him that much this season. They haven't played him, I think, in the starting 11. We've played them both times so far this season. It's interesting. Don't know why they haven't, but they haven't.
Mendoza with the ball. Decent progress with the ball at his feet. And a throw in forthcoming.
Lushek with a tackle. Oh, he's going to launch it all the way back. And we're going to take it off him.
Giving the ball away.
That's not where I ran with it, just for disclosure purposes. I was going along the way. That's okay. We've got the win here.
Mendoza with the ball.
A dominating performance, which is exactly what we needed. Signal that we still want that championship trophy.
Roberts. Phillips.
And we'll stop at nothing to get it.
Harry Wilson delivered into the area.
Sterling should header. Well, he does. Loshek continues the heading pattern. Anisimov.
Well, let's see what they have in store for them.
Banks could be through here.
Well, it petered out.
Oh, wait. No. Okay. I thought for a second. Everyone's tired. Everyone just wants to get to end.
And the book has
to be honest, so do I. I'll be happy with a 4-0.
Here is De Bock. Mendoza. Roberts. Mendoza. Join Alan McAdally now, because there's been a goal in the Burnley match.
Burnley's
Alan,
got a goal in their game.
Burnley. 5 minutes remain. 3-0.
Burnley winning 3-0, so it's a good job we've kind of won up them. Unless Leeds score here,
Mendoza,
which he could.
With the ball, making excellent progress with
no,
the ball that
couldn't. Sterling just sends Mendoza off the pitch as well. Beautiful. And now Loshek. This time he will go past without problem.
What take advantage of that
we've missed.
From close range.
How close does he want to be to score? He's gone for power and fluffed his lines.
Dude, I should have gone with Loshek. I don't know why it took so long. I panicked when I was in that scenario. Turned the way to shoot or pass it. And obviously I picked the wrong option. Because we missed. Just how it goes. 4-0 lead though, so I'm not really too fussed. And we also have Everton to look forward to next, so
1 minute remaining.
Be fun.
Now Chibicki. We've been waiting to find out. Now we know a minimum of three.
Sterling out of position for about the 15th time in this game, most likely. Kakache heads it nowhere. Are you joking? I knew that was going to happen. Headers don't seem to go anywhere for some reason. Carbonero doesn't seem to pass for some reason.
This looks promising.
I don't know, I'm complaining, we're 4-0 up. Possibly 5 here from getting that break on.
It's a weighted pass.
And the ref's going to let us have it.
It might be.
Oh, just defending, let me turn in and shoot. Like, fuck's sake, dude. 4-0 though. Impressive performance. Exactly what we wanted. Exactly what the doctor ordered from this game. Greenwood ends his drought. Haaland hits 30 for the season. Other goal coming from Banks as well. Carbonero doing all the work for that, and Banks just finishing it off. Final score though at the Valley Parade, Bradford City 4, Leeds United 0. And you love to see it. Let's take a look. 10 shots to 6 on target for us, 7 shots to 2 on target for them. They had 60% possession, we had 40. Man of the match goes to O'Leary with 9.3, Haaland with 9.2, Banks with a 9, Greenwood with an 8.6, Carbonero with an 8.5, Loshek with an 8.4, Kakachi with an 8.1, Sterling with an 8. There's 4 players that went below 8 in that match. It was Tomori, Todibo, Rossi and Anisimov, and they all even played good, so don't know what's going on with the ratings there. Man of the match for Leeds was O'Shaughnessy, just Shaughnessy in the defence with a 7.6. Cassia getting a 6 rating in the goal. Burnley did get a win, so it's lucky we absolutely buried Leeds there. Still a point ahead at the top of the table.
Just a couple of questions for you.
Today's match marked the end of Greenwood's rather drawn-out scoring drought. Can this be a turnaround in his fortune? Didn't realise it was such a big issue, but yeah. Hope he keeps up. He was definitely looking fit out there, and I'm glad he's had a turnaround. For the team's sake, I hope he keeps up. Depends if he starts against Everton. I don't know what the fitness is going to be like. Carbonero's continuing his hot run of form. How satisfied are his performance today? Oh, he's a legend, honestly. Like, I might just keep him just because he's a really good player. Even though his rating's kind of low. Deserves all praise. Carbonero is a fantastic player and he deserves all the praise he gets. I hope he can continue to amaze us with performances like these. With two goals to secure, Wayne Haaland was the hero today. Any thoughts? Unstoppable beast of a scorer. Impressive performance. Very impressive the way Haaland played today. It was a world-class performance. Keep praising him and he'll keep delivering.
Thanks, that's all the questions.
At least I'm hoping that's the case. Right, we'll simulate up to the next game. Oh no. Unfortunately, negotiations with LaSalle and his agent have reached an impasse as we couldn't reach an agreement on contract terms. Based on your guidelines, they weren't willing to accept an offer below 54k. Ugh, fuck. So he'll most likely gone somewhere else now, unless we can get another offer in for him perhaps, I don't know. That's kind of sucky. Got a load of messages coming through here. Bolivia have come in for an international management offer. Hold on a second, guys. Sorry, it's my ear. But yeah, Bolivia came in, and we're going to say no to that. Fredrickson has been loaned out to Preston North End. And because of that, obviously, the loan move to Moriarense is broken down. Virtus wants a match against Everton. I'll consider it. We'll see what happens. Might put him in. I don't know yet. But our next game, of course, is against Everton in the round of 32 of the FA Cup. Before we do go, though, I will show you guys the league table quickly. There we go. We have one goal difference ahead of Burnley. 1 point ahead of Burnley. And one win ahead of Burnley. So, very tight at the top of the table now. We've slipped a little bit. We haven't completely fallen on our faces yet. That might come later. Hopefully we can continue to not fall on our faces. But we've got two big games coming up next that aren't even involving the league. We've got Everton in the round of 32 of the FA Cup. And then Man City in the semi-finals of the Carabao Cup. The second leg of that. Of course, the first leg, we drew 0-0. And Huddersfield to finish off the month. And before we do go, like I said, although we didn't get Lo Celso, and we may still be able to go for him if he hasn't gone somewhere else already, we did get... where is he? Okay, obviously he's not in here. I'll have to go into the old transfer hub. We might not have got Lo Celso, but we did get Youri Tielemans, 25 years of age, 87 overall. Lo Celso has just been an extra addition to a packed midfield that it looks like we're going to have next season anyway. Sessegnon's a guy I kind of want to sign outright next season. The rest of these guys as well are kind of just people I want to possibly get, perhaps. I definitely want a new goalkeeper, and Lafont would be the main person if we have enough money for him. Jonathan David as well, striker. He plays cam and centre forward as well. I don't know, just think about that towards summertime. These aren't going to be January transfers that I make because we've not got much money. I'm going to try and go for more pre-contracty players. And before I do leave as well, might as well check, see if there's any more. Mason Mount, not on there. Because, well, I mean, technically he is on there, but he's signed a new contract. Rodri, signed a new contract, I think. Let's just go in the transfer hub and see. Yeah, dude. Been nice if he came up a little bit ago. He's 90 rated, and he would have been fucking sick. Zaracho, pretty sure he... signed a new contract. Ceballos signed a new contract. Not been approached by Paris. And you can see there, Youri Tielemans joining Bradford City when the transfer window opens. Dude, hopefully some more come through. Nah, he's looked great, to be honest. I would like to get Mason Mountain, but I'm assuming he's unsignable on the pre-contract now. Yeah. We'll just have to keep trying to find people. We may go back in for LaSalle, so in fact, if he's not gone... to I believe it was Leipzig who went in for him. If he doesn't go to Leipzig, I will give it another college try and put the money a bit higher. But that's going to end another episode of the Bradford City Career Mode. We get a 4-0 win over our local rivals, Leeds United, stay a point clear at the top of the Championship, and we go into the round of 32 game against Everton with all the momentum in the world. But that's going to be next time. I hope you guys have enjoyed, and I'll see you very, very soon when we do take on the Toffees at Goodison.